Okay, what was I doing? Oh yeah, okay. Hey guys, and welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Zelda, A Link to the Past. In the previous episode, we started the second dungeon in the game and got the power maidens of doom, and now we can lift stones. That's pretty great, actually. Not gonna even get a lie. And we've got this guy here. Let's move this and make everything unsymmetrical. Oh god. And get the key and completely disregard that the floor is about to attack us. Hell yeah. There's probably some other hearts or something in that room that you might need. All right, so we're going to finish up this temple, shall we? Or dungeon. I always keep calling it dungeons temples because of Ocarina of Time, mostly. Or, like, six of the dungeons are temples as well. Unlike this game, where they're, like, palaces. Well, you'll see later on. They're mostly called palaces. Ooh. Like, the East Palace, I think, was the first dungeon. The name of the first dungeon. Anyway. We need to... Oh, God. Not get shot by lasers. And we need... Oh, we need hearts. And key hidden under the third pot from the left. And now we need to be patient while the floor doesn't attack us, because we can cheat by just standing in the doorway. Or we can, like, stand in the middle of the room and swing our sword repeatedly. But unlike other Zelda games, you can't just hold out your shield and have the floor, like, hit the tiles, hit your shield. Which is what I would normally do in, say, like, Oracle of Ages seasons and Link's Awakening, but in this game, you have to cheat by standing in the doorway. It's like an earthquake. The best place to stand is in the doorway, underneath, like, beams or something. Anyway, so with that out of the way, let's stock up on nothing. Oh, it's a key, okay. Let's fight. Well, let me get out this. We're gonna try this on the boss. Oh, we need this first. I forgot that there's actually preparation room before these bosses. Later. Oh my god, I forgot. These guys are only affected by this. There we go. I forgot that the early dungeons of the game have preparation rooms. Some of the later dungeons will not have preparation rooms, and you'll just find yourself suddenly upon the boss, and then you need to hope to God that you have a fairy or a potion or something. Anyway, with that all out of the way, here's the boss door. I don't know why they bother putting it behind a locked door, but that's pretty cool that they did. Alright, bring it on, mofo. So basically, these worms, oh god, are gonna come out of the ground, and if you hit their head with the ice rod as they come out, which is actually pretty difficult to do, so I probably won't end up beating the boss this way. Mostly because, yeah, I missed a couple times, and now I'm out of magic. But spin attacks work just as well. Well, okay, that's a lie. Spin attacks do not work just as well. Because the ice rod actually does significantly more damage. But we'll finish him off this way. It's actually, they only take two hits from your ice rod to hit, which I think is the equivalent to three spin attacks, I want to say. It might be two spin attacks is the equivalent. So basically every one of these takes four spin attacks, or eight hits. But again, don't quote me on that, I'm not entirely sure. At least I have fairies, though, because I kind of screwed up the whole thing with the ice rod. I missed a lot and misjudged the timing. All right, so this last one is going to get a little bit crazy with the way that he shoots out those little balls. You want to make sure you're kind of, you know, at an angle to him, even though it's not supposed to go at an angle. In this case, it is, because they're going to go in, like, eight directions, so. Oh, goodness. Ow. And again, with the game throwing multiple enemies at us for a boss, that's not really fair, ganging up on me like that. Oh, almost got him. I hope this is one that I've hit with the ice rod. I don't think it is, though. Oh, because as you can see, it takes quite a bit longer if you screw up with the ice rod. Ah, no, I wanted to get him before he went in the ground. All right, I think it's probably one more hit. Yeah, there we go. And we get a piece of heart. Hell yeah. So that was the end of the dungeon for you. And now it's going to teleport us out of the dungeon, that door. I don't know why it didn't take us out of the front door, but that's okay. It takes us to the last door we went through anyway. All right, so we're done here in the desert, and I'm just getting hit by everything because I'm very, very careless right now because I'm on my way to the next destination. We're going to be picking up quite a few items in between here and the next dungeon, which is up on the mountain, which is the last one before we can get the Master Sword, as Sahasrara told us to do. Once we get all three of the pendants, we can go get the Master Sword. Master Sword. We can pick up all these rocks now. Actually, we can probably go under some of these. I think there might be a fairy fountain or something somewhere. Let me just look, because I'm curious. Haha, you screwed up. I think it's under this one? Yeah, there's something here. Oh, it's this guy. Ah, this is the cave that I was talking about with the unlimited rupees. Basically, you can come in here and you can get a total of 50 rupees from getting all 5 of these rupees. And every time you leave and enter this cave again, those rupees will respawn. Ah, strange and wonderful things. So I guess that's the cave that first bandit guy was talking about back in Lost Woods. All right, so now we need to go to the river. So we're going to make our way up to close to where we got, well, actually past where we got the magic powder. So we got to go on my way there now. Whoa, dodge that. Dodged a bullet just now, except it wasn't a bullet, it was an arrow to the knee. Yes, Link takes arrows to the knee like a champ. And he's still an adventurer. All right. Anyway, going up north, doesn't take that long with our newfound... Oh, hang on just a moment. Here's a rare sight. And I kind of want to talk about this a little bit. Oh, look, on our way there. Come up here, see this sparkly rock here? When you find a sparkly rock like this, and I think it's only in the Game Boy Advance version, and I don't think these are in the SNES version, but if you slash these a load of times, you're going to get a bunch of rupees from it. Not that we really need rupees, but eventually bombs will start coming out, and when they do, just kind of stop. Green bombs, nonetheless. Oh, rupees, you're mine. Let's go this way. Yeah, so those are relatively rare. There's also... Yeah, it's only those small white rocks that turn into like the sparkly ones. And they'll give you a load of rupees if you need them. So it's always good to stop and get those, especially at this point in the game, because we're going to need a lot of rupees anyway. So we might as well, you know, pick as much up as we can now. Especially now. I mean, we're going to go to a place right now where we're going to spend a lot of rupees. You are going to want 500 total rupees before you come to this place, and you'll see why in just a moment. Now that we've got the power glove, the power mitten, we can lift those big-ass white rocks and not run into those guys. Ooh. Those guys act an awful lot like Chews from Wind Waker and other Zelda games. They look a bit like Chews, but I don't think they're called Chews. I think they're called something else. They also look really, really immensely goofy. Oh god, I'm dying. I didn't even notice. That seems to be a running theme in this Let's Play. Me not noticing how low my goddamn life is. Alright, anyway, so we are in Zora's River, and these are Zoras! And they're just like the ones in the original game, which I'm a little bit disappointed that we never see this style of Zora again. Luckily... Ugh. What is he doing? What a weirdo. You're in my way. Thank you. Luckily, jumping in the water accidentally does not do any damage. I think it might in the original game, but in the GBA port, it does not. We need to make our way through this maze of sorts. Let's go this way. I think this is the right way. Watch out for their fireballs. I'm a little disappointed that they don't have this style of... Oh, I went the wrong... Went the wrong way. I always keep tripping over my words in this episode. I don't know if you noticed that. Oh, goodness. I think your shield can block fireballs. I'm not sure, actually. Oh, no. This shield cannot block fireballs, but you can get another shield later that will. Stop jumping in the lake. River. Lake river. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. What's coming out? It's an earthquake. It's a giant whirlpool. It's... Well, hello. Whoa, what do you want, little man? Do you have something to ask me? I want the flippers, son. I want the flippers. I want them damn flippers. I want them flippin' flippers. 500 rupees? Okay. I have plenty. I'm rich. I will let you use the magic waterways of the sea folk. Yeah, so now we've kind of opened up a warp of sorts. We're going to get more into warping around the world later, but we now have a way to warp around the world a little bit, because we can swim into whirlpools, and they'll take us places, which we'll probably do in just a moment. We'll see. Depends. First of all, if we want to come over here and get this piece of heart, makes it mega easy for you if you come here after, right after you get the flippers, instead of, like, going out of your way to get it later. But there is more to this place than meets the eye. Let's go back. Let's go back to the beginning of the, well, outside of the river anyway, the Zora's domain, and come up this way. And of course, there's always hidden stuff behind waterfalls, so let's go here. Mysterious pond. Won't you throw something in? Throw an item into the pond. Yes, of course. So if you throw your boomerang into the abyss below, except that's not abyss, it's a lake.
A beautiful fairy will appear, huh?
Yes, I did drop it. I like an honest person. I would give you something better in return. Something better? What? And for that, you get the magical boomerang. You can throw this faster and farther than your old one. I believe this, in some Zelda games, it might be just Minish Cap. Your magical boomerang, the magical boomerang you get in that game actually will... You can actually control it, which is kind of cool. So there's something else you can get here as well. If you throw your shield in, your little tiny itty-bitty blue shield that you got from your uncle, and just kind of casually throw it in the water, Mr. Beautiful Fairy will give you... Aha! The red shield! Your shield is improved! Now you can defend yourself against fireballs! Fireballs?! Yum! My shield just eats the fireballs. Like Yoshi. Oh, goodness. Okay, so, now we've pretty much got everything we wanted to get here. Ow. Let's use one of those warps to get back to where we want to go. Let's use this one here. There's... I think six warps, and this one takes you to Lake Hylia, right down here. Oh, goodness. But there are other warps that take you other places as well. Let's come up here and see what's up with this. This is another place where a lot of rupees comes in handy. Hello, Pond of Happiness. Throw some rupees in and your wishes will surely come true. Yeah, I'll throw in a few. 20. Hell yeah. A little luck. And I think this affects, there are, there's a couple chance games in the game. I think, oops, I did not mean to do that. There's a couple chance things in the game. I believe that, depending on what your luck says here, like if you have good luck or bad luck, you'll do better in those chance games than you normally would. Throw in a few, I'll throw in a 20, another 20, you know, why not? Okami makes a little bit of a reference to this, actually. I'm not sure if there's too many games that actually do this, but Okami does this as well. Yeah. Happiness is 80. We'll have good luck today. And you can keep doing this to get better luck as well. But if you throw in 100 total rupees, Mr. Fairy will appear. And then you can choose whether or not you can carry more bombs or more arrows. So I'll be doing a little bit more of this off-screen, but, yeah, because it's going to take a long time to throw in a bunch of rupees. However, if you do come back here, you can throw in 50 instead of just 20, so that helps you quite a bit more. But have great luck today. So what I'll do is I'm going to increase my bombs and arrows, like, back and forth. But I'll do that off screen, and I'll tell you about it in the next video. For now, we'll just do that and move on to the next thing. Right now, we're gonna go get another bottle. Yes, get another bottle because bottles are most important. I don't know why I just spoiled the item we're about to go get, but that's okay. For those of you who've oh goodness, oh yeah, okay, it's up here. It's over here. For some reason, I thought it was to the left. For some reason, I have no idea why. That beeping is really getting on my nerves. I really wish I had health and wasn't terrible at this game. It's not that I'm terrible. I don't know. Sometimes I have a little bit of trouble, especially when recording. All right, so if you go under this bridge, and I never knew this existed. Like, it took me forever to actually know this existed because it doesn't look like you could really go underneath the bridge, but you can, and there's this hobo here. Hello. Wake up, fool. Wake up. Kamiyoba, yo, Link, you seem to be in a heap of trouble, but this is all I can give you. And he gives me his bottle. That's a very generous hobo there, giving a rich kid his bottle. His only bottle. He probably drank all the alcohol that was in it and decided just to throw it away. So we just saved that bottle from being littered. Look at that. Look at us. Also, a notable change, you can actually dive underwater in this game. The original SNES version, you could not dive. And that's basically to dodge the fireballs and stuff from the Zoras. As well as Link eating the water. Alrighty. So in the next episode, we're actually going to go up Death Mount. Oh, wait. You know what? Let me heal myself. Oh, I thought this was a fairy fountain. Never mind. So in the next episode, we're going to take our leave and go up Death Mountain. Yes, Death Mountain. And achieve the third, I wanted to say piece of heart. Achieve the third piece of heart. Yes, in the next episode, we're going to achieve the third piece of heart. I'll see you in the next one, guys.